made many mistakes, things I regret. I've always dreamed I'd do something with my life, something greater than what I was destined for. My grandma always told me I'd be a lawyer or a banker, something successful. Well, I made something of myself. You'll see my name on banks, headlining stock reports, and newspapers. I came from nothing and gained everything, but at what cost? I feel nothing but emptiness and moral dissatisfaction. My name is Joseph Howard, and this is my story.
Joseph Howard?
Yes, sir.
Willard Schwartz, come with me to my office. We'll talk there. So I've been told you're my guy.
Your guy?
Yeah. There's an associate's position available. Should you choose to take it, you'll get into the financial structure of the company. You majored in business, I believe. First out of college? I'm sure you have debt.
Economics, actually, sir. I'm a couple years out. And yes, sir, I have a lot of debt.
Even better then. We will make this a promotion, and your debt will be wiped clean, sir.
Thank you, sir. I'm not exactly sure what to say, sir.
No need to say anything at all. Make it out of time.
Oh, I did make my way into the financial structure of the company. I learned the ropes. I completed several mergers, shut a few folks down. I eventually convinced Schwartz and Astro to break out into banking. That was the day my name made headlines. Joe Howard, a regular guy from regular whatever, now in charge of JT Howard Financial, the newest force in American money.
Just send me the numbers and I'll run them when I get them, alright? Just send the numbers to me. No, I don't want any excuses on why you can't. I don't want a sob story. I don't care. Just send me the
number. Do you understand what I want?
Yeah.
Good. Good. Just know. Just know that if you interfere in any way, career is finished.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, David McCilroy, Belmont Capital.
Joseph Howard.
Hey, you guys want to go to lunch?
Yeah, sure. That sounds good.
All right.
Okay.
Though there's something empty about it, something cold. Schwartz always told me that to succeed in this business, you need to cheat. And if you're not making enemies, you're not doing a good job. There was no room for sympathy, or so I thought. It was in the fall of 2013 that Schwartz showed his true colors. He cut people. Good people. And the layoffs gave him incredible profit. So in response, several accountants devised a system of cheating Schwartz out of his funds. We placed investment cash from Schwartz International into temporary firms. The investments would, in turn, amount in direct gain for my associates and I. We were gradually feeding off the rich cat, and it was foolproof. We were getting filthy rich, and investment requests from the firms increased, and Howard Financial grew to be as big as Schwartz. And I even moved into his neighborhood, bought a truck. We covered up the financial increase with buyouts, our prestige on Wall Street expanded, and I was man of the year.
Wallet.
Go get it. Oh, hey, I got it.
Alright, cool. Thanks.
Yeah. You know the story about the wolf dressed in sheep's clothing?
I've heard it.
It's ingenious, really. Wolf put himself in disguise as part of the flock so he can get in with the ranks. Once inside, well, you know the rest.
What are you getting at, Schwartz?
I think you know absolutely what I'm getting at. I'm losing money, you're gaining it. You are an embezzler, a fraud. I will see to it that your little tenor on Wall Street is destroyed. We're gonna suffocate the life out of Howard Financial. You're done, you're finished. Rothschild Howard, get off my property. Go on, go.
What are you gonna do?
Let him go. Newspapers will catch wind of your fraud. They'll beat him down, then we'll finish him. I kind of feel bad, actually.
Quiet as they come.
Little guys never know how to respond.
If you sink this, you win.
I always win.
So I killed him, done it out of spite, mostly. They'll never have the evidence that I cheated him out of his money. He was smart, but I don't think he finished the puzzle. Ha! Embezzlement? Fraud? What does he think this is? Elementary finance? The lion always gets the sheep. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar. Go and tell that midnight rider. Tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Well, my goodness gracious, let me tell you.